Hello everyone, welcome to EduTap and also welcome to the government scheme session. So the scheme that we are covering today, that is National Pension System. So we are covering currently Ministry of Finance, and we have already covered a similar scheme to this, that is the Atal Pension Scheme that we have covered in the previous session, and you can find the link in the description box below. Alright, so before starting this particular scheme, this particular lecture, to our new audience, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can also join our Telegram channel if you want to get all the PDFs of the lectures that we provide here on YouTube. So see, yes, Minister of Finance we are covering right now, and let's start with the scheme now. See, one thing that I want to tell you before starting this lecture, that today, that is 9th March 2022, right? So see, this particular lecture, it comprises of all the modifications and all the new revised guidelines that have been released in respect to this particular national pension system. So it comprises of all the new changes that have been done. So do not get confused while listening to this lecture. And after that, if you're watching few months after this particular date, do check whatever the new, the latest changes that have been done under this particular scheme. All right. So let's start with it. So the launch year of this particular scheme, it is 2004, right? So see, this scheme was initially, it was only the government employees, they were eligible for this scheme when this was released. But then what happened in 2009, it was made open for all the citizens of India, all right? So herein you have two launch. So if asked what is the launch year, then that is 2004. But when it was available for all the citizens of India, then your answer should be 2009, all right? And just like Atal Pension Scheme, this particular system also, it is administered by PFRDA, which is Pension Fund Regulatory and Development Authority. So whatever pension should be distributed and every aspect that is related to that, that would be governed by PFRDA for this national pension system as well. All right. So now let's look at the aim, and I think we have a rough idea about it. So the aim, that is to provide retirement income. When you get old, you have a source of income, and what will be the source of income? That will be by generating the habit of saving at the younger age. So whatever saving you are making now, that will act as a source of income for you when you get old and when you are not able to do much of the work for the living, all right? Next are the beneficiaries. So again, this is a modified document, and herein it says that any Indian citizen, because see, initially it was just for government employees, but then from 2009 that became for any Indian citizen. Now that Indian citizen can be the resident, means who lives here in the country only, or non-resident, which we commonly which is known as NRI, so he can live outside the country also, they are also eligible under the scheme. And in fact, an overseas citizen, so there are the overseas citizens of India also, they are also eligible under this particular scheme. All right, so this is the updated version of this particular document, and you should keep in mind this. Now let's come to the eligibility criteria, and let's look at them one by one. So the first is the age criteria, which is 18 to 70 years. If you remember of that Atal, that was still 60, right? But herein that, that was still 40, right? And herein that is from 18 to 70 years. Initially it was 65, and then it was shifted to 70 years, right? Next is all the new, do look at this word, employees of central government services except armed forces. So herein the defense services, they are excluded, and central autonomous bodies joining government services on or after 1st January 2004, because this is when this particular scheme was launched, right? And that is specifically for the government employees. So here it says whoever employees who have joined any government institution on or after 1st January 2004, they are eligible under this. See, now because they have extended this time, this age limit, so now the older people can also apply, because now all the citizens can do. But herein, because that was released in 2004, this particular scheme was launched in 2004, so at that time, according to that, this particular criteria is set. And because see, in this NPS system, there are various options that you can opt for how you want your scheme to be, how you want your returns to be. So for government employees, there is some different criteria, and for normal citizens, there is some different criteria, and that is why it is written in such form. Okay. for the employees of state government, because still they would be government employees, right? But in case of central government, they have given this criteria, and it's in the case of state government, they have this authority that whatever respective notification that the particular state has released, in accordance to that, the employees, they would be eligible or not eligible under this scheme. Okay, so herein, it could be maybe 3rd February 2006 and whatsoever, right? So herein, they have this liberty, the state, whatever notification date that they have released, employees will get benefit, they will become eligible accordingly. Okay, and one more, any private sector employee and unorganized sector workers, they can also enroll themselves under this particular scheme. All right, so this is the eligibility criteria, and now let's look at what are the key features of it. Starting with, say there is some record keeper who keeps record of who are enrolled under this particular scheme and everything regarding that. So that record keeper here will be the National Security Depository Limited, that is NSDL. In fact, for your Atal Pension Scheme also, this particular organization, it takes care of the record of whatever entries that have been done under the particular scheme. All right. Next one is talking about a particular identity over here. Okay, so just like we have Aadhaar number, that is specific to every person, right? Similarly, a unique number is given for the pensioners as well, and it is permanent retirement account number, which is portable. You can port it from one account to another, bank to another, okay, used from any location in India. Okay, so it's give you an ease if you are someone who keeps on getting transferred, right? Then you can easily submit money under this particular system, because that number which you will get, that would unique number, that is portable, and it can be used from any location in India. So it becomes an ease for you to save money. And lastly, NPS is structured into two tiers. So there are two tiers under this. The first one, it is compulsory and non-withdrawable. Okay, so this one you can only get when you retire, and this is the compulsory one. Okay, while the second one, the second tier, it is, first of all, it is not compulsory. Okay, and secondly, what is it? Is withdrawable, because this is something that you are doing on your own, you are volunteering for it. That is, it is something that you can withdraw whenever you feel like. Okay, so there are two tiers to it. First one, that is compulsory and non-withdrawable, and second, that is non-compulsory and withdrawable. Okay, so now let's look at some of the tax benefit under this. So see what happens. You can get an additional tax reduction up to 50,000 in addition to the 150,000 limit that has been assigned by the government under Section 80 CCD. See what happened, there are some tax exemption that is given by the government, that if you are investing in PF funds or some other long-term investment in government, you have a tax reduction of 150,000, deduction of 150,000, right? But what happens if you're investing in National Pension Scheme, in addition to this, you can have deduction of up to 50,000. So in addition to 150,000, you can have tax deduction of 50,000 if you are investing under this particular scheme. Okay, so that is a good thing for people. Okay, and second is, government has increased the income tax exemption limit. So whatever you will get out of this particular system also, then also you will have some exemption in that, and that is now is 60%. So what does it mean, when you will take your, whenever you this particular, under this pension, your account will get mature and you will receive your money back, in that case 60% of that money, it will be exempted from the tax. All right, so herein, that is a good news as well. Okay, so from it, initially it was 40, and now it has been shifted to 60%. So 60%, that is you won't get any tax in that, you won't have to pay any tax in that. Next, now let's look at what are the withdrawal and exit rules. Okay, so herein, the first one is superannuation. So this is a simple one, when you reach your maturity age, and then in that case, what you have to do, 60% you can withdraw at the moment, very moment only, and rest 40% you will receive as pension. Okay, so that is a superannuation. For premature exit and partial withdrawal, we'll look at what is it in the few slide afterwards. And then after that, whatever the lump sum that would be there of your income, that would be given to the nominee that you have appointed. So there is no about spouse nominee that we looked at in the Atal Pension Scheme. Okay. So now let's look at the premature exit. So if you have been reached to the age but you decided to quit it, in that case, what would happen? You can only apply for premature exit if you have completed 10 years. So this is a normal case I'm talking about. For the people that have joined the scheme after 65 years, we'll look at what are the conditions for them after a few slides. But herein you have to look at, but for the normal condition, you can only exit from this after 10 years. And also one more thing is that if corpus it is less than or equal to 1 lakh. So there are two cases, that whatever amount you have submitted, if that is equal to 1 lakh or less than that, or the other case is that it is more than 1 lakh. Okay. So in case of if that is equal to or less than 1 lakh, in such cases, you can avail to withdraw all the money. Okay. But if that is more than 1 lakh, in that case only you can get only 20% of it, and rest 80% you would get afterwards only. Okay. You cannot withdraw it as such. And the rest, whatever is there, you would get it when you reach the retirement age. Okay. So that is the for the premature exit in normal condition. While talking about the partial withdrawal, partial means some of the money you have withdrawn. So this you can do maximum up to 3 times, and that would only be allowed if you have completed at least 3 years into the this particular system. So if I have completed, if I'm saving the money and I have completed 3 years, after that I can withdraw only 3 times. And one more thing, that should be of genuine reason. You cannot just apply to withdraw money for any skill development or self-development activities. You cannot withdraw for unnecessary things. Here what government wants to say. Okay, that is for the partial withdrawal. Okay, now let's talk about people who join after 65 years, who are 65 above. Okay, because in that case they can't just we can't expect them to wait for 10 years for premature exit or anything like that, right? So for them we have some different norms, and what are these? Let's look at that. First is normal exit will be after 3 years. In that case, we because here and they are already 65, right? How much can we expect them to be a part of the system? So they have this particular condition that after 3 years they can leave the system. Only up to 60% tax-free withdrawal will be made to the subscriber. Means they would have to give tax on the rest 40%, and 60% would be made tax-free. Okay, next is, now there is also two conditions. First is if the corpus is equal or less than 5 lakh. So in such cases, what will be done? 60% of the withdrawal amount will be considered tax-free, that we have already studied, right? So if that is equal to or less than 5 lakh, they can withdraw everything. But in that 60%, that will be that would be tax-free, but the rest 40% will be taxable income. Right, so that is in the case of the exit we are talking about. But if we talk about premature exit, that is before 3 years, after 3 years they can withdraw from the scheme. But herein, if we're talking about premature exit, in that case up to 20% tax free withdrawal will be allowed. So only 20% tax free withdrawal will be given to the subscriber. Okay, and if amount is less than or equal to 2.5 lakh, in that case also again 60% amount will be tax free and balance is taxable, that is 40%. Okay, so because this is a lesser amount, so in that the government expects that they can withdraw the entire amount, but then again 60% will be taxable, tax free, and the rest 40% will be taxable. Okay, so I hope that is clear to you all. Now let's have a quick revision of that. So see, the launch year of this scheme is 2004, but it was available for all the citizens of India in 2009. Ministry is Ministry of Finance, and it is administered by PFRDA. Talking about aim, that is to provide retirement income and to inculcate the habit of saving. Okay, beneficiaries are all citizens of India and NRI, OCI, that is overseas citizen of India. Everyone is can be a part of it. Age criteria, 80 to 70 years, central government employees, state government employees, and private employees, unorganized sector, anybody can be a part of it. Okay, So that is all for today. The homework that you have is, who is the chairman of PFRD? Because for two consecutive lessons we are studying about PFRD, but who is the chairman of it? So you comment down. And before telling the toppers of the last session, there is one announcement that flash sale is going on, and you can avail up to 50% off on our RBI courses, that is for grade B 2022 gold package, silver package, and also sigma, that is for RBI assistant 2022. This is valid only for today, that is 9th of March, and you can use this code FLASH50 to avail this particular offer. So these are the toppers of last session. Kiran, she said the right answer. I asked you about PM Kisan scheme, that how much the spouse or nominee gets after the pensioner has died, after retirement age, right? So that was 50% of the pension that gets. Manpreet, thank you. AFS, thank you. And yes, the answer is correct. Then start to karo, set the correct answer. Rohit, welcome. Janani said the correct answer, and Raj, thank you. Okay, so that is all for today. If you have any query, comment down below. I'll definitely reply to that. Thank you.